What's got you all bumfuzzled over there? Get going!
Mimir, I still don't get why you ever wanted to work for Odin.
Back then, I was young enough to still be ambitious. The Aesir gods were as powerful a force as I'd come across, but they clearly lacked for strategy, focus, and sage counsel. All this could I faithfully provide. And so, a stranger from a far-off island found himself with Odin's ear, trusted as he trusted no one but himself. And with that kind of power, laddie, I must confess, there are perks.
Yeah, but he's Odin.
I never claim to be perfect, laddie, only clever. And often too clever by half.
What'd you do to get Odin so mad at you?
Well, I can just tell you this story later.
And all were his responsibility.
That's a lot of responsibility.
Does it frighten you? Responsibility?
No. I don't think so. I mean, I think it used to. Not as much anymore.
Why is that?
Well, being out here, with you, makes me feel more grown up.
Strong. Look here.
Another map. Sure, we'll find something useful here.
Thank you.
There's something down there. So what did you do to get Odin so mad at you?
Gradually, as I grew more to care about people and the world, my job became to contain him, to protect him from himself. By serving peace, I served his interests as well. That's the truth. But he saw it as disloyalty. No longer trusting my motives, but not wishing to part with my brain or tongue, he bound me to a tree and adopted a new pastime of casual torture.
Well, I'm glad we came along to cut off your head.
Aye, lad. Lucky break that was.
There was another shipwreck under the water. It's about here. So many men.
He had their loyalty, so they followed.
And then they all died. He must have been a bad leader.
Why do you think that?
Well, he led all these men to their deaths.
But these men chose to follow. Even good leaders make poor choices. You best take responsibility for them. Remember this.
Ready yourself!
father. Were you ever a leader?
Many years ago, yes. I led men in battle.
Were you a good leader?
It is complicated.
Did you
no
ever...
No more questions, boy. Focus on the task at hand.
Yes, sir. That was the last ship. I hope the captain will be satisfied now.
Unlikely. He was determined to put these men to rest himself.
But he would have never been able to.
That does not matter to him. Our victory will only remind him of his failure.
Then... Father, why did you really want to help the Spear?
You need the experience.
I've had plenty of experience fighting these things. What's the real reason?
This man inspired loyalty. He took responsibility for his mistakes, and he was determined to fix them. These are good lessons for you.
Oh.
Yes. Oh.
Mimir, you never told me what happened with the Stonemason's son.
Well, I can just tell you the story later.
My...
That's right. We killed... We laid them all to rest.
I see. So even in death, I am a failure.
But in life, you were honorable. strong-willed, and you inspired loyalty. These are good qualities, aren't they, boy?
Yeah. I couldn't believe how many men followed you here.
I thank you for your kind words. May your journey have a more pleasant end than mine.
Well, you're right. You didn't seem very satisfied. I guess you never really get over losing ones you care about.
Never.
Something down there. The mirror.
You never told me what happened with the stonemason's son. You said he'd have his revenge?
Grimthor, son of Thamur. After completing his father's masterwork, the Great Wall of Jotunheim, he thought of nothing but making the Aesir pay for their crimes against the giants. Once, he longed to fight Thor, but tragedy had brought wisdom to Hrimthor and cunning. He observed that Asgard's walls were half-built and shoddy, for no Aesir god could be bothered with such tiresome labor. So Hrimthor adopted the guise of an ordinary man and made the Aesir an offer. He would build them majestic new walls, and if he couldn't build them within 2 turns of the season, they would owe him nothing for his labors. And if he succeeded, he asked only for an audience with the goddess Freya. You know what? I'll tell this one later.
Oh,
enemies are strong.
So then, Hrimthor, the stonemason's son in disguise, offered to fix Asgard's walls. Odin agreed, knowing the task was impossible, but intrigued by the stranger. Hrimthor made short work of it, of course. He had the benefit of his father's training and the aid of a magical stallion for fetching stones. Odin was not happy to find himself on the losing end of the wager, but he seemed to uphold his end of the bargain. Freya was sent to meet the mason. And to her surprise, he wanted only to whisper something in her ear. That being done, he made his way out of Asgard. And when he found Thor awaiting him at the gates of Midgard, he knew he had been double-crossed.
And we'll pick this up later.
What's got you all bum-fuzzled over there? Get going! And for Junior? Junior, that don't seem straighter than straight. You make up your mind? Say the word, kid. Now there's something...